Welcome to the online class, children. Today we will learn English first for class third student, and the name of the chapter is the sentence. So today we'll start our first chapter in the grammar part, okay? And first the sentence. The name of the chapter is the sentence. So first of all, what do you mean by the sentence? The sentence is an order, group of words which make a complete sense. Sentence is a group of words which make a complete sentence, and it should arrange in a proper order, isn't it? No, in certain order, then only we can find out the meaning of the sentence, isn't it? So a sentence is an ordered group of words which make complete sense. So definition is clear to you. So first of all, you have, when you will write in your copy, you have to write the definition of the sentence. Okay. Now a sentence should always, now after that, the points are there. What are the points? What are the objectives of the sentence? A sentence always begins with a capital letter, isn't it? No. And it always ends with the full stop. Full stop. A sentence usually ends with full stop. Not always. Sentence usually ends with full stop. It ends with the punctuation mark. It can end with the exclamatory mark also. It can end with the question mark also. Isn't it? No. And it can end with the full stop. But usually a sentence ends with full stop and starts with the capital letter. A sentence usually ends with full stop. So here we will see the example. How it can start with a capital letter and how it ends with full stop. The rose smells sweet. The rose smells sweet. The rose smells sweet. Now this is full stop. No, here. So this is a sentence. One sentence. Example I give of sentence. Now, it starts with the capital letter, the, start with the capital letter, and it ends with the full stop. So, and it has arranged in a proper order. The rose smells sweet. It has a proper meaning. It has a particular meaning to understand. So, this is what? This is a sentence. Now, another thing we will see here. It's clear, no? Now here we will see the incomplete sense. Suppose I do not. Here it don't have any meaning. It is not having any meaning. Okay, I do not. So what I do not? So we have to make a complete sense by making a proper sentence. So here I do not like bananas. Now it has a meaning. I do not like bananas. So that it has a complete sense. So the second part is having a complete sense. Isn't it? No. Suppose, is breakfast eating here? The sentence is not clear and it is not arranged in a proper order. Okay. He is eating breakfast. So now the words are arranged in a proper order and it has a complete sense. So this is a meaningful sentence. Sentence means what? It should have a proper meaning and it should arrange in a proper way. So he is eating breakfast. He is eating breakfast. So now it is clear. Meaning is clear to you. So this is what? Sentence. A sentence can be divided into two parts. Subject and predicate. A sentence can be divided into two parts, that is subject and predicate. So suppose the person, place, thing or emotion that is spoken about, that is known as naming part or subject. Naming part or subject, when we are talking about a person, okay, place, thing or emotion that is spoken about, that is known as what? Subject. And that is naming part. Now the second is, I already told you, two parts the sentence divided. Naming part and doing part. Naming part is known as subject. Doing part is known as what? Predicate. So how we will arrange it? So
subject and the predicate are there. Now, the sun shines bright.
So, example, you see where is the subject and where is the predicate in the sentence. The sun shines bright. The sun shines bright. This is the sentence. It has a complete meaning. Okay. So, the sun shines bright. Okay. Now here, where is subject? Where is the remaining part? The sun. We are talking about the sun. And what suns do? What sun do? What is the work of the sun here? The work of sun here is shines bright. So the sentence is divided into two parts. That is subject and the predicate. So this one is subject. This one is subject. Okay, first part. Now here, this is a predicate. This is a predicate. So this is the second part of the sentence. This is the second part of the sentence. So subject and predicate. And it is also called as naming part. It is also called as naming part. And this is also, this predicate is also known as the doing part. This is known as the doing part. Okay. Doing part. So, naming part and doing part. This is the two part of the sentences which make a complete sense. Okay. So, doing part and naming part. Hope it is clear. Sentence is clear to you. Now, what is naming part? Here, when we are talking about a particular person, emotion, thing, that is the naming part. And what we talk about, that is the doing part. Isn't it? No. So here, that is the describe. Suppose, what is said, described about the person. When we are describing about the person, place, thing. Here we are describing about the sun, that it shines bright. So that's why it's described part. So this is known as what? Doing part. Okay? And that part of the sentence is what? Predicate. And this part of the sentence is known as what? Subject. Okay? Now, hope it is clear to you. The naming part and the doing part. Now, what we have learned in this chapter. So, we will recall it. The naming part in a sentence is called subject. And the doing part is known as what? Predicate. The subject indicates the person, thing that does the action. It is indicate. The subject means it indicates. It tells us about a person, place, thing that does an action. Okay. Does the action. Now here, the predicate is what I already told you, doing part is known as a predicate. So the doing part of the sentence is called predicate. Now the predicate describes the action that the subject does. The work, the action that the subject does. It refers to the rest of the sentence begins with the verb. Suppose the sentence is made up of two parts. That's why I already told you. That's why the sentences are made up of two parts. The naming part and the doing part. The naming part comes from the subject and the doing part comes from the predicate. Okay, and whatever the descriptions we make about the naming part, that comes from what? Predicate or doing part. The descriptions are known as a doing part or that is called as a predicate. Hope you have understood this chapter very well. Okay? Now, we will do the exercise part and I'll give you the PDF of the exercise part. But first of all, when you start writing English first, you have to write in a 4-line copy and what else you have to do? You have to start first with the definition of the sentence. What is the definition of the sentence? Okay? And what is subject and what is predicate? That also you have to write. You need to write the example also. Okay. And then you start your exercise part. Okay.
in the book, and some part of the exercise you can write in a copy also to understand. Okay, thank you.